everyone. How's it going today? John over here turning wrenches. How are y'all doing today? We are on episode 5 of this Murray 17.5 tractor, the free one that I got up the road for me. Last few episodes, you know, we got it running, cleaned out the carburetor. Runs good. Throttle was a little sticky on the, I think, episode 4. I took it and, you know, I sprayed WD-40 or penetrating oil on it. Haven't got it up. Haven't started it up since. And, of course, you know, diagnosed pinion gear was bad on it. And I ordered a new one off of Amazon. And here it is right here. Part number is 690183MA. That's the pinion gear for it. There, so it's only like $8, I think. $8, I think I ended up spending like $10 in tax or something like that, so it wasn't that bad. And the tractor's worth it. It just needed a new pinion gear because there's the other one right here. Because I gotta get use the snap ring that I just dropped. I'll grab it here in a minute. That's the old one right there. You can see with the teeth where they're broke. Of course, here's this one right here. Get it out of the package. Hear the difference? Yeah, that's gonna make a big difference there, and it's blind. Make sure it was the right one. There, so this one's a paperweight right now. And then, of course, I gotta get that snap ring I just dropped. So. I'm going to use that pro lift, lawnmower lift, lift the tractor up so that way I'm not crawling underneath it. I'll bring the camera along and put you guys underneath. We're going to slap this bad boy on and we'll have steering again, and then we'll work on the throttle and adjust the throttle on it and stuff and get it sorted out. So I'm going to bring you guys over the tractor in a second and pop this gear on. Alright, got the lift up here, set up, and put the track on there. I had the brake locked on it. So used to not having a brake on it, now I do got one. There, brake, there we go. Now, pump this bad boy up. Should be high enough. I'll bring you guys underneath the tractor next. Alright, I got you guys underneath the tractor here. That's where it's gonna go. So you can see the teeth are a little off, but hopefully enough it won't affect it too much. So put you guys down here real quick. And hopefully enough you guys will not be in my way when I do this. So let's put this gear on. Like so. Now I'm doing this in my offhand. Looks like I think I got it in there. Yeah, got it in where it needs to be. Okay. See how good it responds. Okay. I guess we won't find out until we get it down there. So, I'm going to go ahead and lower it down. And we'll see how it turns, okay? So, hang on. Bring you guys back. Okay, let me lower it down. Put the foot up here on the thing. Down. Well, that's right, I got the brake on. Duh. Alright. Off the brake. Let's see how it responds now. Should be straight. Looks like it is. Looks like it's responding really good. I like that. Awesome. All right. Let me get a battery hooked up into it, and we'll try to adjust the throttle on it next. Hopefully enough it works after I sprayed it down. Okay, I got a battery hooked up. This one's off my girlfriend's Husqvarna tractor that I'm working on still. I charged the battery fully up. Let's see where we're at on voltage on it. Get it up there. Oh, we're at 12.4, so it kind of dropped down some, so maybe it's enough to start it up. It'll charge it up, hopefully. We'll check it as we go with it. There. Also, this thing needs a foot brake pedal, so I got one to put on here. It came off that other Murray tractor. Since this one don't have one, this one's kind of, it's all right. Should fit on there. Not the best, but hey, it's a foot brake. Better than not having one at all and your foot slips off, huh? All right, let me get the camera set up better and start adjusting the throttle. Let's see how responsive it is first before we start doing anything. I'll go ahead and start it up. Choke, key on. Help you put the brake on. Looks like we got some little adjustments to do on this thing. I mean, it's running good, but it's trying to throttle too high. Full throttle, not throttle. Like it normally would be. You get some WD-40 real quick and spray on that. Oil liquor wrench. Use that. That kind of helps it out a little bit. I don't know if it will, but we'll try it. Let's try it again. Had to adjust the throttle. Alright, I got a T10 here for it. Let's see if that works any better.
Back on choke again.
see how it goes moving. I already see a problem already. We're gonna have the gas tank is leaking right along here. Kept seeing liquid, didn't know where it was coming from, and it looks like it's pouring out from the seams. Well, this is gonna need a new gas tank. I don't know if I got one like this one. I thought this one was in good shape. It don't look like it. Throttle's still a little hinky on this thing, though. Gotta figure out what's going on with that. So I might have to take that bracket, maybe move it back some. We'll see. I'm gonna take the air cleaner off, though, and we'll adjust this throttle link, and I might have to move this linkage back some. Okay, let's see if we can play with the linkage here a little bit. Now, it looks like it's all the way on choke, according to this. I need a little screwdriver to get that one off. No, it's not. I was going to try to use a screwdriver, but it's not going to budge it. I make sure it's all the way on full throttle or choke. It's on choke. I notice the butterfly is not. It all the way. It looks like it's a nut driver I gotta put on here, see if I can bust that loose. So let me get a nut driver with that socket on there and fix that. Got my nut driver here with a 1/4 inch socket. See. Bring that a little bit tighter. There. Almost like the throttle is sticking on it. I don't know if you guys can hear it. It's like making a little popping noise. Let's try it without the air cleaner on. See if it runs a little bit better. Here. Try that real quick. So, let me set it up a little bit better. Get you guys out of harm's way just in case. Alright. Let's try it real quick and see. still running a little high though. I got a feeling we're going to have to adjust the valves here, but it's going to be hard to do it on a warm engine. Probably better to do it when it's cold. So, might have to wait for let this cool for a little bit. And maybe we'll take a look at the valves and see if they're okay. And I need to look up the specs for them anyway to see what they're going to be. I wanted to show you guys real quick on this carburetor. If I show you guys real quick, look where the throttle is. When I throttle it up, it moves up. When I move it back, it doesn't move back. The throttle still stays where it's at. Almost have to push it with my finger to move it. So I don't know if the governor needs an adjustment. Which I don't think it does, because it's not supposed to move all that much. But I hear this little popping noise when I'm on this. So I'm wondering if something's going wrong with this carburetor. So I'm just going to order a new carburetor for it here and try that out instead. So we'll see how that works out. In the long run,
might be better off anyway, since this tractor is probably about 20 some years old. Probably needs a new carburetor on it anyway, much as I cleaned it, but I've heard they're not very good carburetors, the Vector one, which this one is. And this one I ordered, it's going to have the fuel solenoid on it, so I can hook these wires up that are here for it and maybe it'll work. So that's going to do it for episode 5. Carburetor is not going to get here until Thursday. $13.99 off of Amazon there, so we'll try that out. So thank you guys for joining me on this one. We got the teeth fixed on it now on the pinion gear, so now we got that going and stuff. So it's getting there. It's a slow process and stuff, and I need to get a new fuel filter for it, and looks like I'm going to have to try to find out a different way of putting a gas tank on. I got one, but it's not just the right one for this one, getting the bolt in the frame, so I'm going to have to figure out something on that one. Not sure yet what to do. So thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned, follow me on Instagram, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Up to 246 last I checked on subscribers. So thank you guys for subscribing to my channel here. Thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time. I'm turning wrenches.